Hello students, are you interested to learn science? Okay, what we learn today? Okay, I have some paper. Let's do some paper craft. You also do. I have one paper. Now I make boat from this paper. See? Now paper is converted into craft. That is boat. I have another one paper. Here I fold this paper like it makes a flower. See, it looks like flower. It is another craft. Now I have split of paper. What can I do? Okay, I have match box. Now I burn paper to get another craft. See students, okay, see students, here I have paper craft. Second time I burn paper, I get ash. Why this happen? Can you recall? First I take paper, paper is converted into craft. See, paper is converted into craft. Again I open this paper, it reacts its shape. In our previous classes we learn about the changes, that is reversible changes. Are you remember reversible changes? Here paper is converted into craft. Again craft is converted as a paper. These types of changes we call as reversible changes. In second case, if I burn paper, I get ash. Here, ash is possible to convert again a paper? No. Paper is converted into ash. This ash is again not converted as a paper. So we call as irreversible changes. Irreversible changes. Here reversible changes means the changes which is reverse in nature we call as reversible changes. Irreversible changes means the changes which cannot reverse in nature we call as irreversible changes. It is we learn in our previous class. By using these changes, today we are going to learn the topic physical and chemical changes. Topic name is physical and chemical changes. In this chapter, today we are going to learn about the meaning of physical change, chemical change, and what are the difference between physical and chemical changes. Classified as two types. How many kinds of changes? There are two types of changes. One is physical change and another one is chemical change. Here changes are classified as two types, physical changes and chemical changes. First we see what actually a physical change. Physical changes. Before starting the class, let's write down the definition of physical changes. Physical changes. A change in which a substance undergoes a change in its physical properties. We call as physical changes. A change in which a substance undergoes a change in its physical properties. Here, what do you mean by physical properties? Physical properties. Yes, physical properties means change in size, change in shape, change in color, and change in state of a substance. State of substance. Okay, you know size, shape, and color. What do you mean by state of substance? State of substance is nothing but the matter. State of matter. State of matter is classified as three types. One is solid, liquid, and another one is vapor or gas. These are the state of substance. Right? By using these physical properties, today we are going to learn about the definition of physical changes. Okay, here let's we see one by one as physical properties. See students, I have a spring. It's the normal length of spring. If I apply force, what happens? The spring becomes stretched. Now it regains its same size and position. See here, size. Now the size of the spring. Here, if I stretch this spring, the size of the spring becomes changed and it is regained. We call them physical changes are reversible changes. Reversible changes. Okay. In these changes, we can't get new substances or no new substances formed. See, if I apply force, it stretches. Again, it regains same size. Here, we say that these types of changes we call as reversible changes. If we stretch spring, we can't get no new substances. Here, no new substances is formed. It regains same size. So, we call as physical changes. Next, see students, I have a balloon. It is the normal size of the balloon. Now I blow air in this balloon. See what happens. It is the normal size and shape of balloon. After blowing air in this balloon, the size and shape changes. See, size and shape become changed. If I liberate gas from balloon, it regains its same size and shape. If I again blow air in the balloon, I again get the balloon as different size and shape. But no new substance is formed. We are playing with balloon, but we can't get another new substance. These types of changes we call as physical changes. Okay. Now we see size and shape. Next is color. Here I will show some color markers. See what is the color of marker? Orange, blue, now pink. Okay, these colors we can easily identify on the appearance, observing the appearance of the pen. These types, for example, here what is the color of ball? Green, yes. By observing, we can easily say the color of the substance. These types of observing the IR identification of color we call as physical changes. Next, students, I have a candle. candle. Now I ignite candle. See, candle is made up of wax. Now the solid wax is starts melting. Now solid is converted as liquid. See, the falling of wax. Solid is converted as liquid form. Again, this liquid wax again converted into solid form. So we say that solid wax is converted into liquid wax. If liquid wax gets cool, we again get solid wax. Here we can see that the changes are reversible and no new substance is formed. Here solid wax convert as liquid wax. Again liquid wax cool, we get the solid wax. No new substance is formed. These types of changes we call as physical changes. Next one is state of a substance. For example, you know ice cube. If we heated ice cube or at the normal temperature, ice cube starts melted. We get ice cube is converted as water. If we heated water, evaporation process takes place. Now we get gas or vapor. Okay, here ice cube is solid form. Next, water is in the liquid form. Again, liquid is converted as gas. Gas or vapor form, we say that. Okay. See, if solid is heated, ice cube is heated, we get water. If we cool water, we get the ice cube. Here, water or liquid. If we heated liquid substances, we get gas or vapor form. If we cool these vapors, we again get the water or liquid. So these types of changes we call as physical changes, because here reversible change. Ice is converted as water. Again, if we freeze water, we get the ice. Here no new substance is formed, but we use only ice. Here, next, water is converted as gas. Again, gas is converted as liquid or water. This is also reversible change. These types of changes takes place in any reaction, we call as physical changes. Whatever the changes takes place in size, shape, color and state of substance, we call as physical changes. Next, we move on the next change, that is chemical changes. Chemical changes. Write down the definition of chemical change. Chemical changes. A change in which one or more new substances is formed. We call as chemical changes. For example, I have marked it. Now, I ignite this mastic. After some time, the mastic converted as ash. Again, this ash is impossible to convert again a mastic. Here we say that I have agarbatti. I already ignite this agarbatti. If we ignite agarbatti, we get ash. From these agarbatti, we get ash with fume. Okay, you can observe the fume. Okay. I will explain. Here, if we ignite agarbatti, what happens? Agarbatti gives ash as well as fume. These fumes and ash again not combine to form a agarbatti. Okay. Here we can't get the reverse form. So we call it as chemical changes, is also known as irreversible changes. Irreversible changes. Here, as agarbatti is converted into ash and fume, these ash and fumes are not converted as agarbatti. Here, so we call as new product. Whatever the chemical changes take place, we get new substance. Here we burn agarbatti, we get ash and fume. Here we get the new substance as ash and fume. These types of changes we call as chemical changes. Okay, students, next. If we take seeds and soak seeds after some 5 to 6 hours, we rinse that water and these seeds are transferred in cotton cloth. After 5 to 6 hours, the seeds become sprouted. Here see, seeds as converted into sprouted seeds. Is it a physical or chemical change? Yes. First, I take seeds. After soaking, seeds as converted into seed sprouts. Is it possible to convert seed sprouts as seeds? Seeds converted as seed sprouts. Again, seed sprouts is not converted as seeds. Here, we say that irreversible changes because we get new substance. Again, seed is not entered in the first stage. After this, sprouted seeds growing and become plant. Again, seed sprouts are undergoes in next step. Again, this process continuously takes place. These types of changes we call as chemical changes. Next, I have a candle. Now I ignite the candle. I already give example of candle for the physical change. Now I give example for chemical change. Here see that solid wax when melted, it converted as again a solid. This type of changes we call as physical changes. The burning candle is example for chemical changes. How? Here, wax or candle. If we ignite this candle, we get the new product light as well as fume. See here if we burn solid candle or candle, we get light. This light again not considered as candle. Or we can't say light is a wax. So here we get new product. Light with colorless fumes are produced. These types of changes we call as irreversible changes. Here new substance is formed in the form of light. So we call as chemical changes. Next we see the differences between physical and chemical changes. Physical changes chemical changes. In physical changes, if the question has like the differences between physical and chemical changes, first point we must and should write the definition for physical change as well as the definition for chemical changes. In physical changes, we call as reversible changes. Reversible changes we call as physical changes. Here, chemical changes means the opposite of reversible means irreversible. Irreversible changes we call as chemical changes. Here, no new substance is formed. No new substance is formed. Here, new substance is formed. Physical changes is a temporary change. And chemical change is permanent. I show some examples. Can you identify either it is a physical change or chemical change? Let's see. See what this ball. What is the color of ball? Brown. Here we can identify the color. Now I apply force on ball. What happened? The size and shape of the ball gets changed. These types of changes, here change in size, shape and color. These types of changes we call as physical changes. Okay. I have some sheets. See, what is the color of this sheet? Golden. Next, white. Next, green. How can you identify these colors? By seeing or observing these objects, you can easily identify the color of object. It is also come under physical changes. Okay. For example, for chemical changes. Yes, we can see so many examples in our daily life like digestion. How digestion? Yes, if we inject food in mouth or buccal cavity, the food starts digested and food is converted as energy. Again, this energy is not converted as food. So we call as irreversible changes. Here no new substance, here new substance is formed. Here food is converted as energy. Here energy is a new substance. These types of changes we call as chemical changes. In the same way, respiration, burning of substances, these are our chemical changes. If here we burn candles, we burn paper, we get a new product. When we burning paper, we get new product as ash. When we burn candles, we get light. Here also new substance is formed. In this similar way, whatever the things we burn, like wood, leaves, or whatever we burn, these examples are some under the chemical changes. This is about chemical changes. Okay, dear students, today in this class, we learn about physical changes, chemical changes, and what are the differences between physical and chemical changes.